Is it starting?
Am I live? I'm not so sure. Let's check very quickly. Yeah, I'm live. Okay, this is... Let me check my stuff. Some technical stuff that I need to point out and point in. And we'll be ready to do this. That'll be good. Sounds good. Alright. Live streaming now. Live stream number 6. This is Oli Boldador. That'll be my full name. In terms of the internet, I am Oli Art. Art is not my full name. Art is just... It's what I do. Anyway, I'll be live streaming. This is the 6th time I will be live streaming for you guys over the YouTube. Ah, my camera sucks. Over the YouTube. And I will be doing this because it's fun. And mainly because I talk a lot while drawing. So you'll be part while drawing. It's like a let's draw. Ah! I should coin that. So let's draw, not a let's play. Get it? So let's draw. Yeah. Anyway, let's be doing it. I've been announcing this for a while and I just couldn't find the time. Now I found the time. And the schedule is a bit wonky. I'm still thinking of a good schedule for this live streaming session. First I thought it would be good to do everyday thing, then I realized like, oh, that's stressful. So I think I'll be just doing this 3 times a week, possibly 3 times a week, or maybe 4, but not every day. That'll be crazy. I'm not crazy, trust me. Anyway, let's start. And I promise that I'll be finishing the Empress. It's an artwork that I've been doing for a while. Look, I'm gonna show you. I did this prior to me starting live streaming and started recording all of the shit that I'm doing. So, sorry if I've already started. But I always mean to finish this artwork, but I just, it's a mix of I couldn't find the time, and it's a mix of like it gets buried under new projects, and now like, and then I realized last week, like, oh yeah, what happened to the Empress? Oh, I haven't finished it, but I like it, so might as well finish the artwork. Yeah. Oh, hello, 2 watchers. Hi, Francette. So we'll be finishing the Empress. Thank you for joining me while doing this. I am in your debt, whatever. So I'll be drawing. If you want to say something or like, I don't know, criticize my life, you can do that. You can certainly do that. I don't care. But anyway, I'll be moving out the camera and stuff like that. And yeah, I just shaved. Don't I look cute? Anyway, I'll be moving the camera to the side so you can see my hands. That is my thing. Copyrighted. Alright, because who wants to see my face? I don't even want to see my face. So, why the fuck do you want to see my face? Let's start drawing this girl. Woot woot! I don't have a name for her, I just call her Empress. I thought it's befitting. It's quite fitting. Hold on, just... I'm streaming now. Again. Just getting a word out for people to join us. And let's go. Whoa! Relax, Cell! Relax! Tangina, relax! I can swear here. In Filipino. Tangina. Tangina, Cell! Anyway, let's draw. In timely fashion, I always have lots of sketches. I think I'm gonna erase these. Oops. What the fuck do I have? A white layer. What the fuck is that? Did I do that? No, not like that. Alrighty then. First off, I'll grab some references from my database so I can see some references on the side. Like you do every day of your life. Where did my folder go? Folder disappeared. Wow. There we go. References. I want to tap Baker. Baker. Naomi Baker. One of the artists that I follow immensely. And Johannes Voss. J. There you go. Differences on my other monitor, so that you know, sort of I get inspired in a way, or expired, whatever. Alrighty then, getting some references on my monitor and getting a good. Oops, sorry about that. I have a certain page on my book that I want to tap into. Just getting my setup done. How's your day, guys? Did you have fun? Did you have fun working today? Look at you. I had fun. Actually, my day is just starting. So, if fun is equivalent to sleeping, yeah, I had fun. It's amazing. Sleeping is amazing. Moving here. Dump. I should really get the chat window. No music? No music, because I'm scared of copyrights. Isn't it enough that my voice is the music? It's enough for me. Besides, yeah, get your iPod or something. Yeah, that's enough music. Might be even better. Alrighty then, let's draw. Alright, my reference is on the side, and my other reference is on the other side, and let's get to working. Now, there's an added pressure because one of my friends is in the chat. Hi, Cell. What's up? I'm gonna merge this. Merging. Now, my first concept for this girl was a sort of I had the reference. I forgot. Let me draw it up so I can show you guys. The reference was some sort of queen on I don't know where it is. It was a queen in the throne. So that was the idea, and I thought it would be cool to draw something like it, because the composition is really strong. The solid blocks, a solid block of rectangular shape of the throne is really strong, and the added sword plus the added, you know, it's really strong. So I want to do it, so that is why I really want to finish this artwork, even though I kind of forgot about it. I'm sorry, I'm doing it now. Anyway, oh, thanks Lulz Amp. Hi guys. So anyway, let's draw this girl. So the base idea is that she's an empress. She's a sort of a warrior queen of sorts. My first idea was, hold on, let me pull up my first sketches of this girl. The first idea was she's a sort of a queen, but she was more subdued. The first concept was she's a lot more subdued than this. This one. This one is the first sketch of her, and she was more. A friend recommended that. To make her more warrior-like, because the idea is already there. Like, the sword is there, the breastplate is there, but the skirt is sort of a cheat, because it's like, you're just covering the leg, so like, you could add some more details to it. Hi, Bea! So that's why my friend told me, like, might as well make it into greaves and stuff. So, For that, I have a reference here. I bought this is like my first figurine that I ever brought. It was from WoW when I was just this girl. I love the legs, so I'm gonna get some reference on that. I'm gonna sort of copy it and incorporate it to the artwork. And these sort of, I don't know what they're called, skirt, metal skirt, side skirt, or skirt. I'm gonna use this as a reference for the lower body. And for the sword, I don't know, I'll get something over the internet. But yeah, I'm gonna grab this and gonna so that she'll look more warrior-like, and possibly change the shoulders, especially her right Because it looks a bit... Eh. Yeah, it looks a bit eh. It's nothing interesting, so... I might want to change that. So, we're gonna continue back. Just explaining really quickly on what to do. On what I do, basically. And... Basically, yeah, we're gonna continue. Where's my pen? Found it! It was in my pocket. Bloody pocket, mate. I don't know how to do British accent. I apologize if there's someone British out there watching. I'm not that good. Anyway, we're gonna copy that and we're gonna continue drawing it. So first off, we're gonna get that sort of plated legs. Plated legs feel. I'm gonna do a different layer for that. We're gonna change the sort of layering later, but for now we're gonna to make it more simple, like not bothering much with the layers. I'm gonna make it just one layer for now, and just separate it later. All right. I'm not sure if I can finish this today, but I will do my best. If I can't finish it today, well, then I'll finish it tomorrow. Derp. Because this is one of the artworks that I actually really care about, and I want to finish it 100%. Like 100%. I wasn't able to say it. Sorry, just posting it on my DeviantArt. Anyway, continuing. Alright. I'm gonna do some values check from time to time. Yeah, the value seems good. It's not 100%, but it's good for now. Just getting those lines across. Just that plate feel of the art of the legs of the shin. It's called the shin. Keep forgetting. Alright. This might be a boring session to think of it, because I'm just rendering it. So, if you want to chat, if you want to talk on the channel, go right ahead. Not that I'm forcing you, but it's heavily recommended. Just add some interaction here, you know? Have some fun. Make it cloth or something, yeah. Let's make it gilded. Like on the sides, like golden probably. At this point, I'm just blocking in colors. Really just blocking them colors in. Yeah, the gilded works. Let's add that visual interest. Just add that visual interest on the artwork. There we go. Yeah, gilded works. The shape might be wonky, but we're gonna fix that in a few. But for now, we're just focusing on getting the shapes right. Yeah, the gilded would work, because it will give a more visual representation of the foreshortening of for the legs, especially. There you go. Grabbing him red. Red is such a strong color. Using red is just awesome. Just really striking. There we go. Just blocking him in. Like some happy little colors right there. Yeah, we're gonna use the golden gilded colors to like sort of lock them in more generalized idea on how they where they go. There we go. We're not gonna use full black in the end. We're gonna soften this later, maybe like up to here. That subtle detail adjustment. Something like that, or maybe, oh fuck you. Yeah, subtle adjustment on the detail. I don't like using harsh blacks. Just not super harsh blacks, just saktong black, just enough black kind of deal. That's why most of as you may notice, some of the outlines are violet. Just to have it as a sort of a back paint? What was it called? Underpaint? Undercoat. Like a sort of an undercoat for the outlines. Because, I don't know, this is a technique I've been doing for a while. I've been trying to do. I've been working out so far. But I just want that. I don't want those. Just a basic black on the colors. Just to have it more fun, I guess. It will depend. But that one is very subjective. It will depend on you. I mean, comic book style is very dark, deep blacks and white, so, you know, depends on to you, I guess. But this is my thing. I always do the undercoat for black, sort of colored, like a dark colored, maybe sometimes violet, sometimes bluish. It really depends. There we go. And this is a sort of a block in for the sides. Alright, there should be like plates here, now that I think about it. Alright, there we go. Yeah, the plates are not that thick. Should make it thicker. Alright, and got the gilded levels on the armor as well. The armor is a bit boring. We might have to add something there. I'm not sure what. Some sort of print. Or like really. No. We're gonna think of some details later. Like some sort of rose. Like these. There we go. Ain't that pretty? No, I'm not doing that. But something like that. Maybe a rose. But not that detail. Alright, let's check. That's fine, but it's attracting too much attention. I might want to multiply, do some darkening on this under the bottom. Just converted my brush to something softer. And as per usual, using a really big brush would really slow down your Photoshop. I'm just getting those like wide strokes across so I can like influence a lot more. There we go. Let's check that. Yeah, there we go. Now let's think of the shoulders. You might want to adjust the shoulders a bit. Yeah. The shoulders. Yeah, I think I have something. Like that sort of something like this, but has like not padding, like it's tied up. That makes sense. Not really padding, like it's tied up on the middle. Not sure what it's called. Not really a professional in fashion. Though it helps if I am. But I am not. Just getting those. Maybe like this. Maybe. I mean, that's a point. It's a maybe. Maybe I have to make it tighter. Yeah, let's make it tighter. Her arm would be like this, make it tighter up to here. There we go. control it a bit. That works ish. It's a bad tangent though. This one's a, we can adjust that, but it's fine. It's nothing spectacular, but it's fine. Let's do another rendition. Okay, like thumbnailing on a more detailed level. Like shoulder pads? You can have shoulder pads. It's fine, I guess. Yeah, we're just thumbnailing anyway. No pressure or anything. There we go. Well, that. I mean, that's fine. The shoulder pad is a bit low. Maybe increase it to here. Just, you know, doing this. That kind of works. Kinda. Let's try one more. How about the samurai thing? Yeah, I'm like a long one. Or like a, you can have like a connection here. Like a, the connection for the robe, for the cape. Yeah, we can have the cape connection here. We're gonna make it gilded anyway. But it's gonna blend in. But it's a good fabric, something, elements. Alright, later, friends. Something sort of like that kind of level of detail. Alright. Let's make it alrighty. Oh, yeah, that's good. That's good. I think that's good. I think I'm not so sure, but I think it's fine. I think it works. There's a lot of I thinks. Hold on, let's show you that. Nah, this one's the most boring one. How about like this? Too heavy on the armor. Yeah, maybe just remove the armor and like just I think the cape is too regal. I think. Yeah. The cape might be too royal, given that's what I'm going for, but I want the mix. I mean, do I have something that is similar to the concept of this one? Okay, I think I have something. Let's try something else. Something like this, but more subtle. I just copied it and just erased it, like, way to go. Alrighty then. Was keeping it real. Like a plate, like a one shoulder plate. Like instead of that kind of round plate, but more of like across the arm plate. If that makes sense. Ish. I don't know, but we'll try. All right, we'll do some various sketches anyway. Let's see what we can figure out, or let's see what we can work out with. Ta-da! Does that work? No, if you're gonna do this, we're gonna modify the whole arm. It's not gonna be that puffiness. It's gonna be like not really boring, but more of like a more sub, like a basic shoulder or tunic or dress kind of arm sleeve. We'll just leave it at that. How about that? I think we're just overthinking this. Yeah, I think we're just overthinking it. Yeah, we may just leave it at that. Yeah, I think a more subtle thing that we can do is maybe add some sort of connection here. Yeah, I think that's the thing that's more best we can do. Like some sort of like, so that it can connect here, the cape. Because for now it's like, oh, where does it go? Does it go just here? Does she have a half cape? Is she a hipster? Yeah. So we're gonna make a continuation. But I don't want it to be super, like, I don't want it to be on the nose, kind of. I don't want it to be like this. I don't want it to be the other one. I don't want it to be like this. This one is... She looks too snuggled. I think that's the main point. I don't want her to look too comfortable or too narcissistic. Because, you know, I want her... Yeah, I think Odin from Thor movies could encompass the thing that I'm thinking about. Like, because she's a more... call this hands-on kind of leader, so looking snugly doesn't really help her. So besides, upon her personality like that, she won't really have something that would really sort of you know, kind of impair her in terms of movement. She would choose something on the go, like in terms of a restaurant, she would choose something takeout rather than bite-sized takeouts rather than eat something big on the restaurant. Ah, I'm good at analogies, you know, in case you guys don't know. Come to think of it, this might be a good one. You know what, I'm doing this one. Yeah, I'm doing this one. Fuck that. We can hint it later. We can hint the other cape, the other part of the cape later. Yep. I'm doing this one. Like, let's double check on the actual references of this. I might be wrong. Oh, hi, Des. Welcome to the stream. Renaissance fashion? Female? I'm so good at Googling. Like a Google master or something. Is there I think I've seen something like this. Like, we're not looking for exact references. We're just looking for something similar. Similar is fine. Oh, something like this. Yeah, I found it. I think. I might be wrong. No, maybe not. Hi, Des. Thank you. Give me money. Just kidding. I think that's enough. Yeah. We're just gonna do that. Oh yeah, found it. Found the sort of idea that I'm going for. Like something like this. Yeah, like, you know, like that. You know, it's tied up with strings. Am I right? I'm right. So, so I'm going for that. I'm gonna put it on the other monitor because I'm cool, and we're gonna get back to it, as you said. Alrighty then, let's get back to drawing. Now the details are done, or like the base details are done. I mean, not the full details. I won't publish it as a finished artwork, but we're gonna add some gilded stuff here. Let's get something yellow. Like, but not too much yellow. Like, saktong yellow. Just enough yellow, if that makes sense. Enough yellow is cool yellow. Alrighty then. Alright, just you know, faint. Because it's cloth, so there's some sort of like disruptions on the yellow. If that makes sense, I'm not sure. Let's try it anyway. Yeah, something like that. But I think this is a bit too orange than yellow. Alright then. We're gonna add some details on the cape later. Not sure what. Alright. And oh yeah, last details on the flags. I did conceptualize there will be flags on here on the sides. Not sure which one. I'm gonna go for red and blue. Not harsh red and blue, but just in terms of colors. Or like make them both blue. That'll be a good contrast against our Red Queen. Should they call it a Red Queen? You can't call her Red Queen. It's cool. Should we make it that she's on the Iron Throne? It's a bit weird, but we can make it. Let's do some values check. Yeah, that's fine. Alright, at this point we're gonna do some rendering. We're gonna detail this bastard. We're gonna start with the face. I'm gonna get my brush. Should I separate them now? I'm not so sure. Should I? Thinking about it. Let's do it later. I mean, or separating him now would be not really change much. Alright. First off, let's detail the face. I mean, the face is fairly detailed at the moment. We just need to clean it a bit. Let's get our soft brush, soft textured brush. Opacity 100, and we're ready to go, go, go. Alright. Alright. I think this part is the most boring part. How's your day? I think I'm gonna receive my laptop tomorrow. Yay! So excited! I'm gonna get a laptop. I'm gonna have a mobile device finally. Or like a mobile... At least if I go to a vacation now, I can work. You know, that kind of laptop. So, yay! Finally getting a laptop. I went for the Surface Pro 4 because the Surface Book is a bit expensive. Actually, my first target was the Cintiq Companion. And then the Cintiq Companion was a bit pricey. It was like 140,000. Yeah. So I was like, no. It's a bit expensive. I'm just looking for like a sort of a diet mobile device anyway, a laptop that I can work with but doesn't need to be too strong. So I went for the Surface Pro 4 and I ordered in Lazada by the end of the month, like last month, end of last month, end of February, and they I think they're right now they're packaging it. Yay! Hopefully I'm gonna receive it tomorrow. So excited. I'm gonna have a Surface Pro 4. I can go to a coffee shop and work now. Finally. Yeah. Woo! Laptop. I can meet my friends again. Because I have a laptop. I can go out of my house now. Oh my god. It's been so long. Oh my god. So yeah. Hooray. And maybe on the next couple of months I'll get the more Cintiq Companion. Maybe when my PC breaks down, eventually it will break, so I'll get the Cintiq Companion, or whenever I need a more heavier device, heavier in terms of capacity or work capacity, because I'm not expecting to work 100% on the Surface Pro. If I can work on 100% of the Surface Pro, that'll be amazing. But I'm not expecting that. That'd be crazy. Otherwise, I'll just abandon my PC and sell the Cintiq. You guys want to buy it? just kidding. I'm not selling it. Alright. Let's detail the face a bit. Is her eyes too small? Yeah, this is a Cintiq Companion 13 HD. 1-3-13. 13 HD. And yeah, this is what I'm using right now. My old tablet was... What was my old tablet? My previous tablet was a Intuos Pro, the smallest one. Because I'm dirt cheap. And that's pretty much it. And I looked at various sites on what is a good alternative for a Cintiq Companion, and they said the Surface Pro is fine. I mean, I looked at Noah Bradley's review of Surface Pro and Cintiq Companion, and he said Surface Pro works fine. And he reviewed the Surface Book as well. The Surface Book is really fine as well. So, you know, if it's fine with Noah Bradley, I'm fine with that. Excuse me. I just ate, so I'm like, ugh. I ate chicken. Chicken's so good. Don't you just love chicken? She's so pale. Oh my god. I'm not used to drawing pale people. No offense to pale people, but you know, I'm just so not used to drawing them. It just feels like, oh, should I darken it? But I guess it's fine, but it. She looks so pale. Let's flip it. Mm-hmm. Okay, so just that. Mm-hmm, let's give it a more harsher light. Have I thought about the light source for this? Yeah, let's signify the light source to make it easier for us to identify. And for you, Cintiq 13 HD. Yes, I would say yes, it was worth the price. But I would recommend that if you're gonna buy the Cintiq 13 HD, I would say that it's justified that you're doing your work, you using it, you know. So if you're working with the Cintiq 13 HD, it's like a money back. It's I think of it as an investment, because in terms of skill, it doesn't really matter. For me, it didn't really matter when I had a Cintiq or had an Intuos. But the difference was the speed. I drew a lot faster in the 13 HD. So that was like the main thing, because I bought it out of necessity. I was super swamped with work, and I had to speed it up. So I bought the Cintiq 13 HD. And for now, I'm totally fine with this. You know, I don't think I'm gonna buy a Cintiq 27. I think a 27 is the biggest one they have right now. I'll probably buy it eventually, but for now, not in the close future, because I'm fine with this. I'm fine with this kind of screen. You know, this is big enough. This is already big enough for me. I don't need like a massive one. Besides, I want spaces for my books. I like my books everywhere. Or the other thing that would justify buying a Cintiq 13 HD is that you have lots of money. You know, I won't really judge you if you bought the 13 HD. You know, it's just that difference. Yeah, it's a good investment. But for a student or for someone who just wants to practice, I would recommend buying an Intuos or an Intuos Pro. Intuos Pro if you have extra money. An Intuos if you really just want to try out digital for now, or like you're still not sure if you want to go digital or something like that. If you really have money, get the Cintiq if you want. But you just have to keep in mind that it won't really change. It won't, the skill progression in the Cintiq and in Intuos is pretty much the same. You just have a shiny Cintiq. I won't lie, I like the Cintiq, but I can't recommend it because it's freaking expensive. I just can't. I would be I don't know. I feel like I have a duty. Don't buy if you can't, if you don't have the money. It's like $1,000? Yeah, it's $1,000, I think. At least here in the Philippines. And hello, Carl. At least over the internet or over in the US, it's around $800, I think, 13 HD. But in the Philippines, it's $1,000. Yeah, the tax is like $100. Good job, Philippines. But yeah, I would say if you're really using your tablet for work and you need that speed boost, get the 13HD. It's really useful. Really helped me out. I think the speed boost was about, there's approximation, of course. I don't have a, well, I can't quantify it, but it's about 50% increase in speed. All right. Okay, I'm doing hair. And my main reference, or like my main artist reference for hair is always Loish. I just love how she does her hair, like in her artwork, because it's always flowy. I like its flowiness. So let's detail that a bit, like get the flow right. I'm going for a curly hair, if you haven't noticed already. I think I know what's the problem in this one. It's a bit pale. I guess it's, I've already said that already. It's, I'm still not sure if I'm selling mine. To be honest, I have mine here. It's in the plastic, but the thing is, I'm not sure because I might use it. At least I have a backup if this PC breaks down or something like that. At least I have a backup. But if I have, if I eventually decide to sell it, I will tell you. And charge you for like $1,000 for it. But for now, I'm not selling it. You can stare at it and be jelly. But for now, I'm not selling it. Maybe eventually I might. I don't know. It's really close to my heart, so I can't sell. Besides, I'm using both the pens for Cintiq into the Cintiq. This is from the Cintiq, and this is from the Intuos Pro. I'm both using them. So. Ah, mukha mo Desiree. So yeah. Let's continue. Yeah, I think it's more of the case of it's a bit pale. I guess it's fine. Maybe I'm just not used to drawing really pale people. So I'm not used to it, but it she looks aight. It's just, I think I can just still improve it of sorts. Write it in. Oh, in other news, I finished XCOM 2. Good bloody god, that final boss in XCOM 2. Hard as fuck. It was fucking difficult. Oh my god. I was like, what? Is it? This is the final boss, and I was playing Iron Man Commander difficulty. It was freaking that it was super tense. I was like super tense about it. I was like, oh my god, super difficult. It was like there's possible spoilers. Like the setup for the boss was you have to run to the boss area in XCOM 2. After you run through the boss area, that's pretty much like fighting multiple mech, sectopods, and mutants, whatever like that. After fighting through like about six squads, six or eight squads of them, you get to the boss area. When you get to the boss area, you have to kill three versions of the boss. Three versions of the boss. Like, these bosses are very, very hard. But I won't spoil too much on what they do, but they're really, really hard. And whenever every turn there's a reinforcement for the enemy, and I was like, surely the reinforcement will stop, but no, they don't stop. It's just pouring in every turn. It was like, It's the most stressful boss fight I have ever fought. Above the duo from Dark Souls 1. It was so stressful, but it was so gratifying when I finished it. Like, yeah, fuck you, I finished you. Oh my god. But it was like the most stressful boss fight I've ever played. It was amazing. And then I tried the legend difficulty. It was fucking difficult. I couldn't get past the first mission. I was past the first mission, but the second mission always fucks me up. It's like, oh god, this game is hard. So yeah, I've been playing that from time to time, but still can't pass the legend difficulty. So hard, super hard. I mean, she's fine, right? Yeah. I'll stop looking at her face. Stop messing around with her face and like focus on the hair. How did I do the hair for the Dream Thief? I think I like what they did with the hair there. It's just, I have a reference for this hair. Do I? No, those are not the reference for the hair. Do I have a reference for this hair? No, I don't. I forgot. I used to have a reference for the hair. Alright then. Let's detail that a bit. Oh my god! That is wrong as fuck! God, drawing this hair is effing annoying. It's always something fun about drawing hair. Let's just get the... Hey Ryzy! Welcome to my live stream. You finally made it. After all the attempts, or like the multiple invites that I've sent you. I almost got sad. Almost. Thank you for joining us. If you haven't got to it, I'm drawing a preview sketch. I call it the Empress, but well, I'm attempting to do it. Like, I'm still adjusting a lot of stuff about it in terms of composition. Right now, I'm trying to get the right flow for the hair. I think I might do some multiply just to get it right. Like over here, Control Shift M to change the brush mode to multiply. Wow, informative and funny. And then just do some multiply here. Just getting it down there, like getting the flow, and just what we're gonna do the strokes later, the flows. There we go. Let's get back to the normal mode and just change your opacity to 100 again. This is really just sketching out the call this? The hair strands. God knows I hate drawing hair. Fur! No, I hate drawing fur most. They're just annoying. It's just like, it's like hair, but everywhere. So it's a lot more hard. So at least on hair, like it's actually like a compliment to the overall character. But on fur, it's just the whole body. It's just no, I don't want to draw that. I don't want to draw all of those. It's like crazy. So all right, I think we got the flow right at this point. Now, my always sort of philosophy in drawing artworks like this is like draw from the bottom up. So I'm gonna draw the neck first. I'm gonna detail it. Then I'm gonna draw the hair, the cloth first, the her attire first, then the hair, then the sword. You know, I can just remove this. You know, it's time to layer this shit. Look at me, how I layered this stuff. I'm so good. I studied for this, you know. You know, this is the best perk in getting a Cintiq. It's easier to lasso. But if you're not the guy for lassoing, no biggie. It's just so easier to lasso, you know. Look at that, there's a lot of inconsistent lines. I'm so good. This is embarrassing. And I'm on live stream too. Use the pen tool, kids. There you go. Separate that. Did I miss one? Oh, holy crap. That was the toy falling down. There we go. Alright. Move it on the top. And we're gonna do the other parts. Yep, that seems good. That seems legit. Alright, let's do the neck. Should we add some sort of necklace? Or like a neck guard, neck armor? Whatever you call this. Narmor? Hey, hey. I say bad jokes. Or maybe we can push the breastplate more. Yeah, that seems fair. We can push the breastplate more. Yeah, this was the original attachment for the cape. This one. But for now, we're going to push the breastplate towards there. And then we're going to push the details. And you'll be part of the ride. Aren't you guys fun? Aren't you guys happy that you're part of the ride? I'm happy. Alrighty then. Yeah, we're going to further the hair delete at the very late. We're going to detail the hair at the most late, the most latest. Is that even grammatically correct? I'm not good at grammar, guys. How you English? How do you English? I found a good reference for like metal. Metal is so annoying to draw. Not as annoying as hair. God, hair is bullshit. Hair is so bullshit. There we go. Alright, we've gotten the details of the artwork over here. Like a sort of a plating over here. And maybe we have another underplate over here. And we're gonna detail that. What the fuck is this part? It's like, what? I have zero idea what that is. Alrighty then. Okay then. That might be a bad idea, but we'll go with it for now. Alright. Alright, from here we're gonna use my round brush. The round brush. When you're in doubt, use round brush. I certainly am in doubt from time to time. Thus I use round brush. Alright then, let's detail this. Now, in terms of like, we're gonna have a more solid darkness here. Let's multiply this quick. Now, multiply is very easy. I use a multiply and a big brush just to get like a quick lighting, quick adjustment on the lighting on it, because it's faster compared to just using a normal brush and just running around it. It's fine, but I find it more easier because it doesn't really destroy much of the lines that I did compared to doing a normal brush. So that's why I use it. Just a quick darkness there. We're gonna render it one by one. Should I replace it? No. Yeah, it's fine. I was thinking of like changing it. There might be a time that I may need to separate the layer, but not today. Not today, artwork. Not today. Alright. Let's get back to the hardness. Alright, let's get a reference for a full plate. Really quick. I have an open chrome on the other side. Full plate. just Google that shit. Oh, if ever if any of you guys are very, what do you usually do live streams? When? I have no idea. I'm still working out a good schedule. But for now, I think I'm gonna be doing every 10 p.m. possibly. Every Wednesdays 10 p.m. GMT plus 8. I'm still working out. Maybe MWF. Maybe. I might change it, but so far I think that's the best time. If ever I change my schedule, I'm gonna be, what do you call this? I'm gonna be announcing it. But for now, this works, because my first idea was do it every day. I was like, I thought it's a good idea. No, it wasn't. It was eating too much of my time, so like, no, I'm gonna change it. If ever you miss a live stream anyway, it's gonna be uploaded on YouTube automatically, so it's gonna be fine. Let's look for a full plate. This is a good full plate. Alright, there we go. Maybe like this. Oh, that's nice. I like that. Maybe like that. And apologize for the delay on the answers, because mainnet isn't really that good. For everyone that is watching from the Philippines, you know why. Because our net is kind of sucky, so my answers are usually delayed. Either delayed or just I tend to not look at the chat from time to time. Sorry. Alright, the lighting is like this. Just solidifying the lines a bit. Rotating it. Is that a good idea? Is it a good idea? I think it's fine. Like, it's a sort of a detail. Alright, let's get some light. Drawing metal is very, not really tricky, but it's actually easier than drawing everything else. Because the base idea of drawing metal is just having that multiple variants of hard blacks and like a multiple, having it close together, like this, like a darkness, then suddenly harsh white. Like, the values differences on the areas are really big. So that is a good idea for drawing metal. So it like goes dark a lot of the time, like here. I have to go darker. And like that. Main point is like, metals usually have really that strong highlights. They really do. Oh, that's not a good idea. But I have it like this. There we go. Rotate it a bit. Alrighty then. And that'll be just a line, just for signaling. Signaling? Not really signaling, but for giving some hints that it's there. I'm gonna do for darkness. I just erased what I drew a while ago. Yeah, it happens. Let's double check this. Alright, this is the middle. This is the middle, right? Alright. Yeah, that's correct. Let's flip. Let's double check if it's right. Ah, that's the term. It's that, like this. Yeah, this one is a bit two-sided a while ago, so I'm gonna change it. Two-sided, like T-O-O-sided. It was too much on the side. It's like an always. There we go. Is that right? That is right. You never compromise your vision. That's also the other thing that I have a sort of a philosophy on. If you have an idea in your head, you have to do your best to do it as accurately as possible on what it is on your vision. Never do something like, it's easier to close your hand kind of deal. You know, like when you're drawing something and you thought like, oh, I can change the hand because it's hard to draw the hand. It's like, I would recommend no. Like, do your best to make the hand as you initially want it to be. Like, don't compromise your vision. Because that will help you learn, and that will help you get out of your comfort zone. Someone chatted me. No, close. Sorry about that. That'll be embarrassing. Sorry. I should really adjust the notifications while streaming. My bad. Where the hell is that? Whoops, it's here, sorry. That's private. That is not the live stream that I'm looking for. Alright then. Let's continue this. This motherfucker. Let's continue our bullshit. Is that right? That's right. It's just that it's this. This disrupts it. This really disrupts the flow that I had in mind. Like I said, don't compromise your vision. Always, if you think there's something wrong with your artwork, double check, triple check if you want. Do a live stream. Or like something like, ask a friend if there's something wrong. You know, that must be the most helpful thing that you could ever go. Because I learned from self-studying, and I learned a lot from asking a lot of criticisms from my peers. And I learn a lot from that. It's basically just getting it right. Always attempting to getting it right. The point is attempt. Attempt is the key word here. Now, her breastplate doesn't look that shiny, or like doesn't look that interesting. But we're gonna do something more than that. For now, we're just getting the base ready. All right. We're getting the base ready for this fucker. Let's have a more darkened area here. If you have any questions while I'm drawing, go ahead and ask, because this is pretty much a very, what do you call this? This process, this part of the process is very boring, because I'm just rendering and not much interesting thing to talk about. Want me to talk about that stroke? Look at that. Wow. So amazing. It's not really that amazing. Alright, heard the cut will be here. Yeah, this one is parked. This one is quite high. Alright, let's back the rotate. Yeah, that cape is too high. Like, too thick. Let's modify it. That's my dog. He says hi. Hi again. There we go. Check. Maybe a bit more downwards. Lower. High a bit. Yeah, that's fine. There we go. Yeah, I do a lot of those, like copy paste and just modifying it as is. Cause I'm lazy that way. Alright, let's not forget about the main vision. Where is my initial sketch? Like, let's not forget about this. We're gonna have to keep it as close to that as possible. Let's check that. Is that that detail really necessary? I might have to change that. Oh, that's a fair point. So yeah, they can chit chat about problem solving. Let's contemplate about her problems. Her king is gone. Her son is very is like using drugs. And she's fighting that kind of problem. Let's help her. I'm just kidding. And I don't know, I always love drawing women. It's just, I don't know, it's so cool. You know, especially strong women. Like, not women in a sexual way. Although, from time to time, I do draw women sexualized. No, have I? No, I haven't, to be honest. I haven't really drawn someone, a sexualized woman before. Unless it's a nude drawing, that in that case is not even sexualized because it's a more of a study. But yeah, I've never drawn a sexualized female before, so like I always draw them like, I don't know. I guess it's because there's, you know, it's just fun. Plus, it's interesting to see like an empress, like a warrior woman. Plus, I'm a fan of Elsa. You have to let it go. It's a Frozen joke. I love Frozen, by the way. Fucking love Frozen. Now I'm gonna put this one on the other monitor so I can see it easier. There we go. There we go. Alright, getting that line across. We're gonna have to add some print on her breastplate. I'm not sure what, because we need to think about it. Besides, this area is gonna be like covered with the cape. Yeah, I remember what I erased a while ago now. Derp. So it was like this. Alright. Let's add some highlights on this one. It's time to use it. I use various brushes on drawing, but the main brushes I use is this one, chalk. It's not chalk. And this one, round. I know this one because I made this. It's a round brush, slanted a bit. And I use this one for like blending in blood checkered textured. This is my blending in textured brush. Also, as much as possible, I don't zoom in unless I'm doing details. If I'm gonna do a detail like what I mentioned before, like some sort of print or like some sort of embossed stuff, I'm gonna be zooming in. But for now, I'm working on details from afar. It's a lot more, not that it's easier, but it's so that I know if I'm the details I'm doing is good in accordance to everything else, you know. Not that it's good as a standalone, because that is the one that you really want to do. Like, everything has to make sense as a whole, not just as one element as into another. You can make this part as good as you can, but if it doesn't fit of the overall theme, you're fucked. I curse a lot, by the way, if you're sensitive to that. You can leave. I can handle myself. There we go. Doing some deets there. I guess, as I mentioned, it might not be finalized. Where's my plate mail references? Oh, there we go. Looking at references over the internet. Google is really good. Really handy. Also, I'm open to suggestions for scheduling, because right now the schedule for these live streams are very, very open, really, really open. So if you have a better suggestion of a good live streaming schedule, then please do tell. For now, I might do this. For now, I think this might work. Previously, I did a 1 a.m. GMT plus 8, but it turned out to be very tiring for me. But I chose that before because it was the perfect hotspot for my internet. It was the fastest time when my internet is on. So that's why I did that. But right now, I was like, but no one's watching. So I might probably do this, GMT plus 8, 10 p.m. So every MWF, possibly Monday, Wednesdays, Fridays. The previous live streams were done. It was done over like Friday, Saturday, Sunday. It was everyday thing, and it was kind of stressful, so I changed it. There's something wrong about this over my initial sketch. I think it's because. Where's my red line? Red line! No, that's not red line, that's my dog. Yeah. Her anatomy is fine. Just double checking, talking to myself. If you haven't noticed, I do that a lot. That's pretty much it. I'm really sorry about the dogs, seriously. They're going crazy about something. Possibly a cat. Or like possibly talking to the neighbor's dog. Highly likely, either or. It's fine and dandy. Like a fine, like I'm doing a very classic plate meal, like a full breastplate meal, like a breastplate. So I'm not really adjusting too much. Or like I don't want to, I can make it size, but the thing is I don't know, I don't feel the other's designs as good as the others. So besides, I want her very Renaissance-like. Renaissance-like. Yeah, right. But we're gonna adjust it as we go on. But besides, we're gonna adjust it. We're gonna add some more details. I can still make this plated, you know? I mean, we can try that right now. There's nothing else. We're like, there's like, there's the whole lot of adjustments. No, this is fine. Yay, it worked. Good job. I mean, what are the advantages of this over the other design? She would look a lot more. I guess the main point is, with this, it would look a lot more regal. I think. Because I always believe there's always a trade-off in anything else. There's always a pro and con among every thumbnail and every design. So, having it half and. There has to be something that is different. For now, we'll stick to this, you know, and we'll see if it were the other parts will work on the future. We'll figure it out. We'll figure it out together. Should I coin the phrase "Let's draw"? I don't think that's been coined before. Has it been coined? That'll be fun. I can call me live stream. Let's draw. That'll be catchy, right? Because I'm pretty much just drawing. That's pretty much it. At least it's more fun, right? Tell me I'm fun. I'm just kidding. I don't need it. All right, let's get something red. 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 Let's do something. Control Shift F, soft light, make it redder. When in doubt, make it redder. Because this one's a bit more orangey, and we're make it redder. This is very red. I prefer this kind of a spectrum. I'll probably finish this artwork before I get back to like sketching ideas. And I mean, I guess that's pretty much the point why I kind of figured why it's not feasible to do the everyday sketch, because I ran out of ideas. So, MWF seems fair, because I always do some sketches every day anyway. Okay, I think I'm seeing the need. Did I freaking freaking merge the fucking arrow. Swine. Way to go, Ollie. I think I'm finding the need to separate the background, the gray background. Want it. Fucking hell. Sorry. I don't know about this. I think this is the quick one too. It's pretty much bullshit. We're gonna change it to the classic magic wand. There we go. This is how lazy I am in magic wanding, or like selecting. Look at them. So good at magic wanding. Don't be a responsible artist. Use pen tool. Don't do what I do. Seriously, fine, I'm gonna lasso it. Damn it. There we go. Oh, we have these parts. Forgot about these parts. These bullshit. Alright. Deselect. Sounds good enough to me. There you go. What am I gonna do? Let's just fortify it. So that it won't bleed too much. So that the bleeding is not there, or like the colors are not there. Let's have the parts erased. Done that. And they're just figuring out which one is erased or not. There we go. And we have our separations. Good job. Now we're gonna do erase tool here. I mean, that was pretty much the reason why I wanted to do a separation, so I can use the erase tool easier. Get back to detailing this bitch. Alright, that's a fine detail there. Let's do the cape. Let's do a line. Well, not that obvious. Rotation tool. Yeah, just a hint that it's actually connecting. It's always like that. There always have to be a reaction to every action. Something bullshit like that. Alright then. Well, this was reminiscent of the cape Ezio have, really. Ezio Auditore di Firenze. That half cape, because he's too cool for a full cape. Yeah, this is very similar from the one he has in Assassin's Creed 2, the first one. Yeah, I can get some pointers from this. Something like that. Well, that works. I think that works. Alright. Let's take out the sword for a while. No! Do take note. I won't be uploading, because I don't think I can finish this today. I won't be uploading. I will only upload this once it is all finished. Though don't worry, I will not continue this offline, I think. But I'll do my best not to continue this offline unless I have. Yeah, I won't. I promise, people. I won't finish this offline. I'll finish this on stream. So it'll be more fun. Auditore di Firenze. There we go. Wonder what should I get for dinner? Or like lunch, more likely. Because this is technically my new schedule now, and I This is technically my lunch. What else should I get? Should I get McDonald's? McDonald's is nice. There's not much restaurants close by here. McDonald's sounds nice. Oh yeah, that was the point. Yeah. Oh yeah, I think there's hot dogs there. Yeah, I can cook hot dogs. When in doubt, cook hot dogs. No, there'll be a lot of streaking or like a lot of creases here, because it's the joint. Joints always have creases. Hold on, let me get my chair. Been standing for an hour already. Might as well sit for a while. Standing desk, it helps your spine. Go buy standing desk now. I'm kidding. But you should. No, I'm just kidding. Alright. Cloth is very tricky. It's always tricky. Everything is tricky, really. Because, really, before when I was like, I think I was in a basic drawing class, and my teacher was trying to teach us cloth, I was like, oh, you can't do that. That's impossible. No one can do that. Art is bullshit. It's just crazy. It's just trying to look. I don't even have a proper tip or suggestion on rendering cloth, to be honest. It was at least on drawing hands, drawing fingers. I can give you a pointer or two, but drawing cloth, I just can't. Like, go with the flow. I guess that was a. Sorry. I think that's the best suggestion I could give, but to be honest, I can't give anything better than that. It's like, try to think, at least for me, the biggest thing, or like the biggest breakthrough that I've ever gotten for sketching, biggest breakthrough that I've ever gotten for drawing cloth was like thinking of them as different entities, like the creases. It's these creases, like thinking of them like on top of one another. Like, don't think of them as like literally on top of one another. Think of them like this, you know, like, hold on, I'm checking my camera if you can see. Think of them as like this, not think of them as like this, because it's wrong. Think of them as like curved a bit, like they're behind one another. I think that's pretty much the best suggestion that I can give you. But otherwise, you just have to check them out. Like, you have to study them one by one. They're just really bitchy to draw, to be honest. Especially cloth that are like this. Like huge amount of cloth and stuff like that. I guess the other tip I can give is, like, on joints, there will always be creases. Like, like this, because it's the... This is the elbow? It's the elbow part. Now, if you notice here, you know, like this, there will always be creases. And this is the thing I'm talking about. They're like on top of one another. They're not like, this is a different entity and this is a different entity. No, they're really on top of one another. You know, like, you know, you just have to really check them out. Like, get a mirror. see for yourself. Always get them. If you're in doubt of a reference, try to do the pose in the mirror. That always helps. Something like that. And, you know, that. There we go. That's the best suggestion I can give. You're welcome. There we go. It's all about thinking of them like a really different entity from one another. But to be honest, I'm not really a master of them yet, so... When I am really more confident on drawing them, I'll give you a pointers or two. But for now, like, study them. That's pretty much it. There you go, guys. Study them. Now, let's have a sort of a lock. Is that right? Like a lock. Here, make it golden. She's a queen. Something like a lock, then it goes around her, you know. Yeah, something like that. Did I disrupt the hand? No, it's fine. That's pretty much the deepest I can go. No, I mean, in terms of like the Because there's the arm already. And then as things are going, right? We're gonna do the details later on the armor. You know what? Let's do the details now. Like, that will be our finale topic, as is, I think. Really, I don't have an idea for her. She's a conqueror. I think that's the main point that I had. I mean, there's no context in everything that I did here. The only context that I have that she's... There's a sort of semblance that she's conquered some people. She has a sword, so that's like, oh, yes, warrior, stuff like that. So we can add something here that's more denoting. Like, we can do like a separate idea on how it would help the sort of storytelling. Like a sort of crest, like a family crest, maybe. Or like maybe something scary, like an eagle. You know, something like the generals from the Roman legions have. Like, they have lions or like horses, bunnies. No, I won't put bunnies. It's gonna be hilarious, but you know, she's a serious emperor. So maybe not bunnies. I mean, we can just put like a random, we can always just put random details on it, but having context, I always think that having context is always better than doing random details, you know? So, I want every details on this to be contributing to the fact that contributing to her story. So, what would be a good thing to put on her crest? Feel free to add some suggestions on the chat. It's like mainly I put this chat up to help me in problems, not really problem solving, but helping me flesh out the ideas. To be honest, no, that's not true. Crest. Like a armor crest. Let's check out some ideas over the internet. We can always do like a random wolf, a sword. This seems boring. No, not the sword. Something, or maybe I guess it would help on what idea we have. I think of her as sort of an emperor, but you know, she's really protective about among her people, but she's a real, really, really scary person in the battlefield against her enemies, but among her people, she's like really loved, that kind of idea. So maybe something that going, because everything else is very violent already. Like, all the other details is already contributing to the fact that she's a conqueror. Maybe we can add more details that contributing to the fact that she loves her people. Something like that. So maybe, how do you say a heart? Like a heart? Oh, she's a Care Bear. No, no, no. We're not gonna make her a Care Bear. No, we're not doing the Care Bear. something else. No, not like that. How do you denote? How do you show love for your country? How do you show that? Maybe a crest, like a country flag. But it's already given because she's the emperor or the empress. How do you show that? Let me try Google love for your country. Let's see if something comes up. Country. There we go. Let's see if something comes up. Flag? Or blood? Like, the idea of, like, bleeding for your country kind of deal? Fuck the heart. No, we're not putting heart. Wings? Like an angel wings? That could work, I think. Wings could work. Let's do a quick one. I'm good at art, honest. But we're gonna make it stylized. I guess it looks like she's really nice, you know, because she's angel wings, you know, it'll look like she's really nice. That's something. But let's put it on the back burner and like think of other else. A dog? No. I thought of dog because, you know, my dog is crazy. Looking at other options here. Or our other option is just making the armor more detailed. We can have that option as well. Let's try that. Like, it will add the thickness. I guess that would work as well. But it's still this part that is just boring for me. I think we can still add something to that, nevertheless. Yeah. I'm looking at other references here. We can have some random design, to be honest, but random designs are random. I don't like randomness. Yeah, that could work. But how about the chest? It's like, I'm really dumbfounded what to put on the chest. How about we add, like, a gem? A gem? I don't think that worked. I'm gonna let it get less thick. Or like, I'm looking at other references. How about Ezio? Ezio has that Assassin's Creed crest. Given she's not Assassino. No, Ubisoft will kill me. No. Yeah, I think we can just add more details to it. I think that's the best thing to do, but adding something here. I mean, what was my first idea was again? My first idea was like this. Like some sort of like just like that. Yeah, I guess it works. Maybe I'm just really just overanalyzing this. Maybe we can just put it like that. And like, you know. I don't know. It feels bare. It really does feel bare for me. Like, maybe some sort of like, like, let's see. Let's think about it more. Maybe you can add some more details here. You know, this is why I'm a. Before, I would be fine with just this. You know, with just being bare. But now I'm like, I want to have more details. I don't want to rush any artworks anymore compared to before. So that's why I'm taking my time now. Because before, like, I had an artwork that was really good, but, you know, it could have been better kind of deal. Like, if I really thought about it more, like, it could have been really better, but, you know. Whoops. So I'm like, sorry. And that works. Yeah, that I think that works. Like having that neck guard, like, adds more prestige, in a sense. Adds that sort of prestige to it. Like she's really, really ready to kill you, and she's, you know, armored to the teeth. To add armor to the teeth. Nah, I'm kidding. You know, at this point, we have to adjust this. Because this is like, because this part and this part is really conflicting at this point. I might have to adjust it. Let's erase this. I know, right? It works. So, like, we might have to adjust, like, yeah, we might really just adjust some gilded details. Gilded details. Gilded details. Sorry, I rotate my canvas a lot. We have to adjust this part though, so that it really, really construes, and like it folds to the armor. Like, we'll have some sort of, like, this later on. Like, it's really, like, pushed. Like... You know what I mean. So... We're gonna still modify that, but for now, we're gonna just getting the right deets. Yeah, that seems a lot less boring. Now, for the last part of the stream, we're gonna, like, fortify the details on the legs so that these details are not clashing, because we don't have sharp areas. If ever there's sharp areas, they're like on the side, so it's like really conflicting on both sides. We're gonna modify it. I just said I didn't use black, but derp. Oh, sorry about that. Sorry. Alrighty then. Gonna have like some skirt along here. I'm gonna make it more rounded. Yes, this part still works. Alright, out the room. Oh, sure thing, Risey. Laters! Alrighty then. Let's modify this. Yeah, this part is fine. Like a shin guard, as I mentioned before. And let's make it more plated. I'm like flipping it a bit. We can't see her feet. Like feet guard? Is that the best term that I could get? She has feet guard. Alrighty then. And okay, let's check. This is like a check. And more checks here. With the ladder. Alrighty then. Oh no, it's gonna be construing to here and like stuff like that. That works. Alright, hold on. Given we're still gonna modify the, because these gilded areas is attracting too much attention, we're still gonna modify that, like, with, like, maybe let's do a quick adjustment on that. Quick multiply. There we go. Alright, let's see. Let's do a quick red line for anatomy, because I think I have something wrong. Okay, let's do this one, my most... Okay. Okay, that one's wrong. I have to modify it a bit. Okay, that seems correct. Okay. Okay then. Alright. Now we're gonna look at it without them deets. Seems correct, right? Let's flip it quick. Sorry, my PC's crap. Yeah, that's correct, yeah. And that's pretty much... Yeah, I think I'll end the stream right there for now. Let's see our previous iteration of the Empress. Mm. I'm not sure about the gilded areas, but we are gonna modify that later. But she does look a lot more heavier in terms of like she's a lot more focused and she's a lot more armored and a lot more detailed for that. For on the one on the right, she seems more because she given the one on the right us a lot more sort of prude, for the lack of a better term. Like a lot nicer. This the other ones on the left is more battle ready kind of deal. Yeah, I can go with that. And yeah, I think we're gonna push it more. Still unsure about the gilded areas, but otherwise it's fine. I really think we might have over detailed the gilded areas. Let's try turning it off. Maybe it's just me. Possibly it's just me. Yeah, I think I may have detailed the gilded areas too much. We're gonna modify it next turn. Next turn, no. Next live stream. It's always good to take a rest when looking at the artwork and then come back to it and you'll see something wrong with it. So this is pretty much the version but longer. But don't worry, I'll be finishing this in live stream. I'll make sure of that, and I'll be seeing you on Friday, I guess. I'll do a live stream on Friday and continue this. It will be on GMT plus 8 about 10 a.m. at 10 p.m. 10 p.m. or 9 p.m. either or. You just watch out for my announcement on Facebook, DeviantArt, Twitter, Tumblr. I'll be doing the announcements there. If ever, yeah, I won't be uploading this. Yeah, I'll probably not upload this because it's really not finished. But I'll be. Should I upload? I'm not really sure. I'll think about it. But if I ever decide to upload this, I'll be uploading this on DeviantArt, Tumblr, and my Facebook. So, thank you guys for watching. For anyone who caught me, and I'm sorry for the dogs. They're a bit crazy. Stupid dogs. And that's pretty much it. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you again on Friday. Ciao!